When you think about the challenges for ITS ConGlobal that come with weather, it's important to first understand that everything we do is outside. So planning for the weather is paramount. So before tomorrow IO, we of course always have planned for the weather. Our approach would be at best inconsistent. Each site leader might use their own preferred application, and more regional or system level leaders might use more general applications. Now we have a common platform in tomorrow IO that allows us to program our protocols for severe weather and then also understand the implications of that weather at a more precise level. Every day we have operational planning calls where the first thing out, the foundation of our conversation, is using tomorrow IO so that we can ensure that our workforce is protected, they understand the exposures that they will have in their shift work, and then we make resource plans and service plans around that as well across the network. So one of the best parts of working with the tomorrow IO team is how collaborative they've been. They've taken the time to understand our business and our leaders and our needs. And that's enabled us to take our workforce planning and service planning protocols and codify those into our system. They're built right into our dashboards in a way that all of our leaders understand. And so it's transferable from site to site, business unit to business unit, and territory to territory. With more and more advancements in technology like tomorrow IO, I would expect the supply chain to continue to leverage it to improve the service offering in all environments. There was a time when weather could be used to explain service failures, but now with tomorrow IO, I'd expect there'd be less and less tolerance for weather impacting service.